Hey everyone, 84 Ironhide here, back with another video review. This is the review for Transformers Revenge of the Fallen Scout Class Skystalker. Now this is Skystalker in his drone mode. Very nice Decepticon symbols. You see it says 808 on both sides. Very nice. To some size comparisons. Here he is with Revenge of the Fallen breakdown. So he's pretty big on vehicle mode for a scout class figure. It's just the wings make him really big. He does combine with Voyager class Mind Wipe. It's not too spectacular. I'll show you how to do it. You see these two peg holes there and there. And you just take these two pegs right there, and they just tab right in. And that's all. Well, fold the front landing gear back, and then you can tab it in. Yeah, it's nothing too spectacular. It's not like it's the most amazing thing in the world. There we go. But, you know, whatever. Kind of a neat little thing that they included. They do look good together. But I've been trying to figure out a way to combine them in robot mode. I haven't really found anything that has worked successfully. So I'll keep working at it, and if I find anything, then I'll show it to you guys. But let's get to the transformation on them. You can zoom in. There we go. See the detail a little better. Alright, first thing you want to do, untab these, fold them down, rotate them down, pull it down, and then rotate it down just like that. Okay? Next thing you want to do, pull out his feet, and they'll snap into place. They are spring-loaded. I like it. I'm sure there's a lot of people that don't like it, but I do. And this is actually his battle mode. Now, it is in the instructions, but it is battle mode. So, let's continue going to robot mode. Next thing you want to do are pop off these panels right here. And these are going to become his weapons in robot mode. So, just kind of pop those off like that. Fold the landing gear in, tab it in, fold the nose piece down, pull his head out, like so. Next thing you want to do are just pop these up, like that. Split this here, like so. Rotate it around, rotate his arm around. Rotate it around, slide that up. Like so. And then with these panels, you can kind of position them however you want. Rotate them up. So here you have him in robot mode. Now, having the feet that he does stand very well. Next thing you do is just take his weapons here. He's got a peg right there. And a peg hole right in his hand right there. You just want to go ahead and peg those in. Like so. Do the same with this one. Like so. And there you have him in robot mode. So here's the size comparison for you. Here he is next to Revenge of the Fallen Scout Class Breakdown. So he's actually pretty tall for a Scout Class figure. He's got really good articulation. Hinged knee, swivel at the thigh, as well as ball joint. Ball jointed shoulder, ball jointed elbow. Very nice articulation. So you can get some really nice poses out of them. Overall, it's a really good figure. Pretty cool transformation. Great articulation. Excellent detail on him. My only complaint is that this kind of gray, I don't know, kind of like a offset grayish plastic. I wish it was the silver that the box showed. But other than that, I mean, it's a great figure. It's a great mold. The head mold is awesome. And I like the fact that they incorporated, like, little, you know, battle axes. That's really neat. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the review. This has been the review for Transformers Revenge of the Fallen Scout Class Skystalker. Stay tuned for more.